I was thinking, well, it's 30 years since the machine was launched. A lot has changed in that time in terms at least of what we can do with all the concepts for which the machine was invented. Hence my idea to start a project with sort of indefinite goals and time span, but just to, and so at some level, educate myself about what was happening in AI over the last 30 years.
Okay. Well, to go back, one of the sort of founding premises of thinking machines was that artificial intelligence would require parallel computers. And that's sort of an obvious statement now, but if you recall, there was a lot of people who believed that there were proofs that parallel computers could never work.
Right.
And the reason that I believed that they could, in spite of all the proofs, like, you know, Amdahl's law and things like that, was that I knew that the brain works. And so, and it used very slow components, but a lot of them. So clearly a lot of slow components working in parallel were good enough for the computations that we were having trouble with, like pattern recognition. And there was also a body of theory about how to make multi-level neural networks and train them to recognize patterns. But the computers at that time were so slow that you could only make tiny networks, and it was very difficult to train them and so on. So it didn't really work that well because of the scale, or I believed it was because of the scale. And so I thought that if you made a parallel computer and took advantage of semiconductor technology, which was just kind of exploding at that time, that you would be able to make these pattern recognition kinds of things work. And what you needed was something that would simulate connected networks of neurons, which was why it was called a connection machine originally. And it was not just connected networks of neurons, but semantic networks, linked things. But the general quality was that information was represented in links and connections,
rather than being stored in places or in...
Right. And I had a programming paradigm for it, which is now what's called MapReduce. And so that programming paradigm was then embodied in the hardware. So part of the hardware was a map hardware that broadcast out the functions to be mapped across everything. And then you put different pieces of data in every processor. You send out the function to be computed across it. And then there was another network which did the reduced step of bringing it all back together into something. And so the basic paradigm was MapReduce. And so that is indeed one of the biggest, probably the main programming paradigm today for parallel machines.
The other thing is that I know that MapReduce was the basic underlying part of the Google search engine, which turned Google into started Google as the entity that we have today, which is really dominating a lot of not only technical fields, but our lives.
Yeah, well, Sergey Brin was an early connection machine programmer.
Right.
So it's no coincidence.
And I found his resume from that time online.
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah.
So he definitely, used that and, made it, applied it to the web. As Brewster Kahle was also trying to apply it to the web. But the web didn't really quite exist in when Brewster was doing it. So
was that in the 80s when Brewster was trying originally?
Yeah, Brewster was actually trying to do it sort of before the web. He was trying to do it to the data that was out there on the internet, but there was no common form of the data. So the data was in files. So that's why he made Waze, which was a way of sort of looking at all those files and indexing it. So you could have a search engine before there was a web.
Okay.
So he was a little early in that really the search engine didn't really take off until there was a web. Strangely enough, you know, another piece of this was making big semantic networks. Mm-hmm. And later I went back and redid that project after parallel computers came out. And that was what MetaWeb was about. And then Google bought that. And that's now a big part of Google search now, okay, is that representation of knowledge, the knowledge graph. And in fact, the CTO of MetaWeb is now head of search at Google. So it all comes back full circle.
Wow.